Okay, what we have here is an induction lamp. This lamp is actually a fluorescent lamp, and it just works on a different principle than your standard fluorescents. There's no electrodes or cathodes inside the lamp. In fact, there's no electrical connection inside the lamp at all. And this particular specimen is a Philips QL 55 watt. And if you look up inside the bottom of the lamp, there's nothing there really, just a hole up inside the lamp. And on this little tip here is an reservoir for the mercury, because they do have to have mercury to generate light because they're a fluorescent source. And this piece, the centerpiece, is actually an antenna, and it fits up inside the lamp. And what it does is it's connected to an electronic power supply, which is actually a type of ballast, that gives off radio frequency radiation, magnetic radiation. And when it passes through the glass into the bulb where the mercury vapor is, it excites the gas and the mercury vapor and makes it glow. The mercury vaporizes into the gas, produces UV, makes the phosphor glow, just like any fluorescent. It just does it without electrodes. Has a great advantage because the bulb itself can't really ever go bad unless it gets broken. Over time, the phosphors will degrade some with use, so their color will shift a little and their light output will drop a little. But as a rule, the bulb can last many hundreds of thousands of hours as long as you don't break it. The antenna seldom goes bad. The electronics that run it, which are on this other type of lamp here, sometimes do go bad. You know, the ballasts do fail. So this is probably the most likely part to be replaced. This particular model is a Chinese one that has your bulb, and then around the bulb is the coil. This one has an external antenna instead of up inside the bulb. And this one has a socket that it plugs into, which allows you to replace this if it ever goes bad, which is a nice feature.